Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 17th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 715.
One, ignition. And liftoff of Falcon 9, go Starlink, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B1061, then landed successfully for the 19th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
SpaceX were planning to launch a Starlink mission yesterday, but it was delayed until today. So, the Starlink 639 mission is now scheduled for today, Sunday 25th at 9:34pm UTC or 4:34pm EST. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink launch. The Starlink 640 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 28th at 4pm UTC or 11am EST. Then, later in the week, we can hopefully expect to see a crewed mission launch. The Crew 8 mission is currently scheduled for Friday, March 1st at 5:04am UTC or 12:04am EST. There was an article posted about SpaceX wanting to put Starlinks in a closer orbit. It says, to boost Starlink speed, SpaceX is asking for regulatory clearance to orbit some satellites about 200 kilometers or 124 miles closer to the Earth. Heading to Boca Chica, work is going on at the orbital launch site. There was some nitrogen seen delivered to Starbase. The chopsticks were seen opened and lowered. Here's a look at how the Launch Tower 2 segment is coming along. Also, here's a look at how the expansion of Star Factory is going. The groundwork on the new office at Starbase is ongoing. There was a Reddit post related to information from a document about the second launch pad in Boca Chica. It says, SpaceX reinitiates US Army Corps of Engineers permit application to fill wetland area to construct a second orbital launch pad which will replace the current suborbital launch pad and test stand. There was an interesting article posted with information about the Starship launch cadence that SpaceX wants this year. It says, as SpaceX nears its first Starship launch of 2024, possibly as soon as within 3 weeks from its Starbase facility in South Texas, the company is pressing regulators to increase its cadence of flights. During a press availability this week, the Administrator for Commercial Space Transportation at the Federal Aviation Administration, Kelvin Coleman, said the agency is working with the company to try to facilitate the Starship launch licensing process. They are looking at a pretty aggressive launch schedule this year, he said. They are looking at, I believe, at least 9 launches this year. That's a lot of launches. If you're doing modifications and doing them one by one, that's a lot of work. We've been talking to SpaceX constantly around the clock, coming together and trying to figure out how do we do this. We are invested with the company, so we'll work with them to get them back going as soon as they can. Work was seen being done with Ship 28 as it sits on the Pad B test mount. The Booster 14 LOX tank was seen being stacked in the Mega Bay. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.